Yeah, hello everybody. Today you are witnessing how AKTC is crimping the cover crop. I'm the team leader of AKTC. I'm together with Mr. Leslie De Jager. He's a crop production expert and he is crimping his cover crop. And yeah, I have a nice bunch of flowers here, which are mainly the five species of the AKTC cover crop. You all recognize sunflower. We have sun hemp. Les, is this black or red?
That's the black one.
That's the black sun hemp. We have the pearl millet. We have the sorghum. And your favorite one?
This one, I know it as the Japanese sunflower. It's just out in the bush. It's a weed, and I just reaped the seeds last year. So I know it as the Japanese sunflower.
So it's more or less not a standard cover crop. It's an individual one, which came up very nicely with all that rain we had this year. We are now over 1,040 millimeters. That's more than we had the past 11 years. And so there is no water shortage. And you see a nice cover crop. Unfortunately, you are not harvesting it, you are destroying it.
Well, the hope is, what we want is a live roots for as long as possible. So this is now getting to the point there where it's making seed, as you can see, and it's putting all the nutrients into the seed, and then the plant will start dying. So we don't want that. So we're coming now and cutting the, and the whole idea is now to get it to shoot out and to start growing again. Of course, this one, if this one's cut, that won't shoot out again. Same with your sunflower. When that's cut, that will die. But hopefully the sun hemp, the sorghum and the pearl millet will at the bottom make new shoots that come out. If you can maybe just have a look here where we've cut them. The hope is that there will be new shoots coming out of there. And so long, by doing that, we're hoping to prolong the life of the crop. Like I say again, we want live roots in the ground as long as possible.
Rainy season, so the shoots are coming up. Will they not die during the coming dry season?
They will eventually, but at least it will give it a longer. We've got lots of moisture in the soil, but we will get many more weeks of green cover crops compared to just leaving this to die naturally. So that's the idea.
So that field will be planted again. We are in the center of an AKTC field trial, which is a crop rotation, a cover crop after cover crop you plant.
Yeah, maybe if the camera can go across. So you can see there the cross where the maize is, that is where last year's cover crop was, and then where the cover crop is now, that will be maize again for next year, and where the soybeans is, that will go into cover crop then.
That's a crop rotation, cover crop, maize, soya.
Correct.
And what do you, which advantages do you expect from that rotation? And you mentioned already last year you had a cover crop where the maize is now. Do you already see a difference? Is there an advantage of having the cover crop?
We did, where the soybeans is down at the bottom, we did see definitely a marked improvement where the soybeans was planted after the cover crop, much higher, much bigger leaves. There was a very big advantage in that. In the maize, there isn't another example of where I planted maize that wasn't in the cover crop, not in our rotation. But of course, hopefully we are improving the soil constantly with that, all the organic matter in the roots and also on top.
So it's improving organic matter. Cover, as the name says, you cover the soil. The soil is a major or the most important mean of production for the farmers. Without soil, without a healthy soil, moisture, without moisture, the farmer cannot grow a crop. This is rain fed, it's not irrigated land, So we have the advantages, improved soil. All these plants have a different rooting depth. Maybe you say something about the rooting depth.
Yes. That's the whole thing about the mixture of a cover crop is to get the different layers of roots. So sun hemp, which has got a very deep root, that will go right down to the bottom and withdraw the moisture there. Also making that any subsequent crops would be able, the roots would be able to follow that old roots down quite easily. And then you have your sorghum that's got a root at the top. And then your sunflower's got a different root again, and that's the whole idea of the different varieties to get the different roots in the soil. Unfortunately, also this year it was such a good rain that we never had a period that there was a shortage of moisture, which of course the cover crop planting into the stover would have made a very big difference. But that did not come out this year because of the very good rains we've had.
So one thing is the improvement of the soil. So with the rooting depth, we improve on the soil texture. With these five different varieties of plants, we improve on the rooting depth. So after the cover crop died off, there is more air in the soil, which is important for the coming crop. With the cover on the soil, you don't have the bare soil. So the soil is covered, the sun is not drying out the soil on the top or even in the depth. With that heavy soil, it cracks and it dries out very deep. So we also keep the moisture with the cover crop for a longer time in the soil. These are two advantages. Do we have any other advantages? Soil improvement, soil moisture.
And it is the microorganisms in the soil that's usually in bare soil, they just bake dead within our harsh winters. And with now with the cover, they would be able to stay alive until the new season and then already have the soil colonized.
So we have the soil life is just improving to digest the cover crop. Also, the soil life is protected from UV, from the sun, from dying because of the hot soil. So we have soil life improved, not even soil life. If you see that cover crop, I can hear a lot of bees. You see all the birds in the cover crop, a lot of other small insects. God is producing honey, so a major stake of the honey will come from the flowers of our cover crop. So in general, for the ecosystem, the cover crop is a big advantage. For our farmers who are not irrigating, I believe the cover crop, the biggest advantage is also to avoid soil erosion. So you keep the soil, you see it's quite windy. If the soil would be bare, the wind would take away a lot of soil. If now a heavy rain comes, the energy of the raindrops will be broken down by the cover crop. So the drop is not hitting the soil, so you have less water erosion. And yeah, the biggest thing I believe is to keep the moisture. So that more water is available for the following plant. Anything else about cover crops?
No. Except you must do it and don't burn.
So if you have enough land, set aside 1/3 for your cover crop and go into a crop rotation to avoid monocropping, to increase on soil fertility, to increase on water holding capacity, and to increase on soil life and insect life, which is good for the balance, predators, and what are the other ones?
The bad ones.
The bad ones. So these are basically, in a nutshell, the advantages of a cover crop. Thank you.